Okay. L is the language WW such that W belongs to sigma star. Prove that this language is non-regular. Again, we prove it by contradiction. So we assume that L is regular. Now we consider the what string should we use? Can we use the string 0p, 1p? The answer is simply no. Why?
It's not the same.
It does not even belong to the lamb.
Yeah.
So you have to find a string that belongs to the lamb. So, you know, the Pompic lemma says that there exists a certain length p such that every string s that belongs to the language of length greater than or equal p can be divided. So this does not even belong to the lamb. So we have to find something similar to it that belongs to the language, like this. Does this belong to the language? Yeah. So it has two. This is the first W. This is the second W. So it consists of two identical substrings, or two identical pieces or halves. So you can split it in half, and they're identical, two identical halves. So this string belongs to the language. Okay. So now why? Now, who can show that this string, by using this string, by pumping this string, we will violate one of the properties of the pumping lemma? So why is pumping this? What does pumping this mean? Finding a Y piece that we repeat. If we pump, we will violate the conditions of the pumping lemma. So this language does not satisfy the conditions of the pumping lemma. Why? So what will happen if I pump this? Where should Y be? So Y, you know, XY must be less than or equal to P. So within the first, so the Y must be here. My Y must appear here. My XY is less than or equal to P. So not here that I always select sufficiently long strings. The strings that I use to show that a language does not satisfy this necessary condition of regularity, the strings that I use are always greater than p. Now here, the y must be here. So what I will be repeating here is what? What will I be repeating? Zeros. I will be repeating zeros. And if I repeat zeros, I will get a string that does not belong to the language. Why? Because this half will no longer match the other half. So this half that has p zeros in it, if I repeat a y, if I find a, here is the, again. So you have this. So there is a p zeros and there is a 1 0 0 0 0 0 p zeros 1 and p zeros again and a 1. So if you find a y here and you repeat it, you will get, you will have more zeros here than you have here. So you will no longer have a string that consists of two identical halves. And of course you have to, you know, the only way you can get two identical halves is to split the string here Why? Why is this the only place where you can split the string? You can possibly split the string and get two identical paths.
Because it has to end.
Because what?
It has to end in the one, with the one.
Yeah, because you have only two ones, and each half should have a one in it. You can't have both ones on one side. Like if you split it here, you'll clearly get a string that does not belong to the language, because everything here is all zeros, and here you have two ones. So the only place where you can split this is after this one. And now if you pump here, if you increase the number of zeros in this half, you'll get a string that does not belong to the language. So it just tells you that it will be impossible to check this property using a finite number of states. This is, you know, the intuition here is that it's impossible to check a property like this using a finite number of states. Okay, so let me write this down, even though it's very much the same. Consider the string 0p, 0p. Now, since xy is greater than or equal to p, the repeatable piece y must consist entirely of zeros. For any I greater than or equal to 2, so it will have more zeros in the, more zeros before, thank you, before the first one, it will have more zeros before the first one than it has after the first one. Thank you. Yeah, so what I wrote was for the previous number. So it will have more zeros before the first one than it has after the first one. And since we always must split after the first one, we will not get a string that belongs to the, or the pumping will give a string that does not. So maybe I should change this to pumping. Pumping will give a string. Will give a string that does not. Belong to M. Yeah, so thank you for the correction. Yeah, so the number of zeros before the first one would be greater than the number of zeros after the first one. Okay? Questions?